What? You love who? You love who? You love who? Who? Uh-oh!
Then I go back and get the dogs. No, I use my mind. I'm not using the fucking computer one time. One time I do shine like light that emits from the sun. Don't you know I wasn't designed to run? That's why my tempo is untied. I'm about to leave you motherfuckers brain fried. Like beans, and we fried again. See what's living in the life of sin. But what Roddy living the every year of sin. Guaranteed to knock niggas right on the chin. Better get on the ass. They couldn't fucking pass the class that I administer at last. You feel me going through the grains of time. See what's doing this, I got stranger rhymes. What up, stranger? Nice to meet ya, my name's C. West, yeah, nice to greet ya, shake hand. Don't you know I get down in the B-boy stands with the ones and twos up in the hands. Not talking about no guns, maybe get some turntable fun. I like to have son, I have to go. But don't you know I be doing this, throwing all the edibles shit out the window. Like in those smoke proof, I'm gone. David Blaine, son, poof, I'm gone.
And this is when I used to watch MTV. On any given day on MTV, BET, or VH1, you might catch, I don't know, LL Cool J. Mm-hmm. Fucking Criss Cross. Mm-hmm. You know who else you catch? You know who else you catch on MTV? BET, VH1?
Who's that?
The Boot Camp clip. Yep. Helter Skelter. Mm-hmm. La Fleur, La Fly, it's Gorshka. Mm-hmm. I remember seeing Chino XL on there. Mm-hmm. You know what's crazy about it now? You turn on BET, VH1, and all these other major markets, you know? You don't see any diversity anymore, in other words. You don't see Candyman knocking the boots. Mm-hmm. Actually, you just see that shit now. And everybody is using, they're doing what I call the LL Cool J thing. Mm-hmm. They're going to sing and profess their love for a woman through a song now. You know, and that's what they're doing. They're taking a little bit of LL, because pretty much everybody's riding this coattail. I mean, there's like five MCs that everybody's really pretty much focused on and want to dissect and utilize. So they take these five MCs and they dissect all their parts. You know, it's like they're going to a parts store. You know, I need a little bit of his vocals. I need some of his style. Can I get some of his ease? I need his delivery. They do that.
Sound like good books.
They do. They roll up and say, okay, well, Big Daddy Kane was cold, man. He was a cold motherfucker. I need some of his style, man. I need some of that. Can I get his delivery? Can I get his body?
Can I get his work?
Can I get his wordplay? How about his voice inflection? I like that too. And that's what they do. And it's nobody, the lack of originality is so, we're so steep in bullshit. We have to have waiters on. To get out of this, man. Like you fly fishing. That's what I noticed about the difference in hip hop. It's, there's no diversity anymore. Everybody wants to ride everybody else's dick. You know, I was telling him last night. I go, if you actually told cats, hey dog, all that is an entry level job, they wouldn't even want to do it anymore. Being a rapper, literally a rapper, is no different than you get your first gig at a fast food restaurant and they got you on the fries and that grease is burning your ass up. You ain't shit until you make it off the fries to the register at least. Uh-huh. By a window, the counter. Shit, if you could be assistant manager. But cats, they only see the surface of everything. And a lot of cats are surface cats. You know, my favorite MC is Reed. And these niggas don't read. Cats don't read. Yeah, you ask them what a homophone is, like, huh? As a kid, it was a simile. They don't know what the fuck you talking about. Do you know what a predicate is? How about a verb? The other two type, right? Actually, probably more than that. But, you know, parts of speech, don't even fucking hear it. You don't even read books. But they want to use words, though. They want to use words. Words have two functions. You can either read them, or you can say them. Use your eyes or your mouth, one of two things. Or you can hear them actually. You can shut this all this shit up and just use these and hear them. But like, you guys want to participate and can't articulate. That's real shit, man. Before I even started writing rhymes, I was an avid reader. I still read. I read a lot of shit, not just the same shit. And I just, and this goes beyond just a sports page, dog. Real shit. Just you can't call yourself a reader if all you pick it up is you know, ESPN Weekly or some shit like that, Sports Illustrated. That's, you're not reading, dog. You're not really feeding your mind anything. I can put some numbers in your head too, you know. But it's that's the difference I see. There's no real diversity anymore. Cats used to really, I mean, you used to see, remember Poor Actors Teachers? You used to see shit like that, and now you got BET telling people, yeah. You, and, but you know what's funny? I remember when I first heard Little Brother, I got there. I stole it from my mother-in-law at the time. I stole her the Mitchell Show album. 2005 album came out. I didn't get it until this last year or the year before that. And I was like, wow.
Okay, you stole it from who?
My mother-in-law at the time. She didn't know what it was either. She thought the Mitchell Show. I'll just pick it up. I just pick it up. It didn't even know what.
Yeah,
if y'all don't know, but
that's
yeah.
Some shit, son.
That's some shit, dog. Old woman pick it up. But yeah, it's the fact of the matter that BET wouldn't play her music because they deemed it too intelligent for their demographic. Which really means is the niggas you got watching your station are ignorant. They're stupid. They're beneath you. That's what they really think about you. The BET, they really think you're stupid. They think you don't know any better. So they give you that bullshit. And what's really crazy is they take off the uncut shit. The really ignorant shit you used to play late at night and say, that's just unacceptable. Huh? That's like slapping the crack pipe out your hand and saying, take this heroin. Get that nasty shit out your hand. You know, it's just, it's ill shit, man. It's ill shit. That's what I find funny. No more diversity. A lot of dick riding, and you niggas don't read. Nigga don't read. No, nobody read no classics anymore. I never hear nothing about no Moby Dick. Nobody read no Jack London. Hell, a black man wrote a book called Roots once. Real good story. Real fucking good story. But nobody reads anymore. And reading is equivalent. Reading is fundamental when you want to begin to utilize words to put together a story. Or tell someone how you feel, convey a message. Because that's all rhyming is, that's all MCs do. And this, there is a difference between MCs and rappers. Rappers are not MCs. To be an MC, it's almost like being a preacher. You are called before God to be an MC. He reaches down and says, yes, you have the gift. You're a rapper, you just want to be something. You've seen somebody else doing it like, well, I'm trying to simulate that or emulate that. Look those up. Those are real shits, dog. Look those up. Yeah, that's what cats do. They want to simulate or emulate. I could do that too. I can shuck and jive too. No, you can't, dog, because that's all you're doing is shucking and jiving. It ain't for real. And you aspire to be like those other cats that are shucking and jiving. That's what sampling is even more sickening. They don't want to be, nobody, it's funny, these kids want to grow up to be rappers, and nobody said, fuck that, I don't want to be a rapper. You're a fucking hoe to the industry. You're a fucking hoe. Big guys that pay, that spend really big money, that take long trips to short places, and eat fancy meals, you know, $6,000 meals, they make real money. I never heard a kid say, I want to be executive, of a radio station, or a record company. I want to do that. Fuck being a rapper. But the kids will know, I want to be a basketball player. Because what they're attracted to is fame. Fuck fame. Just because somebody know you, I'd rather be the most unknown cat with all the money than the most known cat with very little. Real shit. That's just real shit. You don't got to know me. And just still pay me.